que pronuncian sus labios de carmín. Palabras que al nacer las lleva el viento.
Dear sir, you were once very kind to Beau and myself, and it pains me to ask you to show us further kindness. But I have nowhere else to turn, and nobody else upon whom I can impose. I will, of course, pay you handsomely for your troubles. My family have turned quite mad and are threatening to send me away to stop my work, which they say is disgracing them. As if their history of absolute moral depravity, utter debauchery, and perpetual drunkenness did not disgrace them enough. I must escape, yet I am kept prisoner here. Can you help? Most days I am to be found at the cabins on the plantation. The main house and all it stood for are thankfully no more. Yours faithfully, Penelope Braithwaite. Yep.
You came. You finally came.
I came.
Oh, thank you, you lovely, lovely man.
Calm down, miss.
Oh, come on, let's go. We ain't got a minute to lose. They killed her. They killed Miss Calhoun. All she wanted was a better lot for women, and they killed her, those pigs.
Who killed her?
I don't know. My cousins, probably, or Beau's. Well, you met them. They're animals. Not even animals. Monsters. Monsters! If God had lost all his powers of imagination. Can you please take me to the train station? Beau'll be waiting.
Beau, why couldn't he come and rescue you?
Well, if they saw me and him together, they'd lynch him and send me off to a nunnery. Or maybe they'd lynch us both. I ain't quite sure. They do so love hanging folk.
Where are you heading?
Up to Boston.
Good. Yeah, I like you up there. Come on. Let's go.
Of course.
I'm in your hands. Just get me to Rhodes Railway Station.
Okay. Let's try and get you a train. And Beau's just waiting at the station in the hope you'll show up. Or I'll show up to help you show up.
He goes to there every day he can. Makes up some excuse or other. I said he would see me there one day soon, and today he will. God willing.
Well. If he's there, that's true love, all right.
I've hardly seen him since the rally. They watched me so carefully, and he's waited, or so his letters say. Our families won't let us out. And then all that business with Aunt Catherine and my cousins. You saw the house. And then Lee Gray and those boys killed. So much bloodshed. You'd think this could be a new beginning, but everyone left alive. They're even more angry.
Maybe anger's a complicated thing to let go of.
Something good has to come out of this awful, awful feud.
That's what I've been hoping.
Beau and I have to be better. Our families were here for years and years. Sometimes I feel like we can't just leave death and pain and ruination behind us. We're here. He'll be out at the front. Will you ride on the train with us a little, just to the first stop?
Fine.
You came! At last you came!
Oh, Beau, my sweet, my best of men.
Oh, I'm hardly a man at all. But I love you, Penelope Braithwaite. Sir, how can we ever repay your kindness?
Some of them jewels would do just fine.
Bo, Arthur's gonna join us. I think we need the support. Please, could you buy the tickets, dear Mr. Morgan? We can't chance being seen.
Sure.
Thank you. We'll meet you on the platform.
Can I have 3 tickets to Saint Denis, please, sir?
Of course. Oh, hello, sir.
Hello, Alden. I hope all is well.
Not terribly, but good to see you.
Hey, cuz. No, hey, no, you leave us alone. Penelope, get back. Come on.
Excuse me, Alden. Get on the train. Get your bags, miss. I got this.
Come here, Yankee.
With pleasure, you goddamn fool. You don't want to come back here without giving you a whipping.
We should have done this last time.
Get on the train, Bo. Go to your woman. Oh, now there's only one of you.
Almost.
All right, all done. That is quite a family you've got there, son.
I know. Charming to the last. Then again, my uncle used to keep his own half-brother as a slave, so what do you expect, good manners?
My uncle used to say things were better the way they were, when he could rape and kill with impunity, and he didn't have to work a day in his life.
Both our families. There's good people in this county, but our families bullied them and drove most of them off, whites as well as blacks, all over this silly feud.
Yeah, well, how to life.
Why have we stopped?
It's best you go on alone from here.
Mr. Arthur, I didn't know you could drive a train.
Neither did I. But if I'm honest, it was kind of fun. And I didn't kill any of us. Well, I killed some of your relatives, but they would have killed all of us.
You are a gentleman, sir.
Oh, no, I ain't.
Yes, you are. Here, I ain't got much money, but these sapphires are worth a lot of money. Old family heirloom.
That Braithwaite treasure. I couldn't take it. Now, let's get you off to Boston before any more of your relatives show up.
That might be wise.
Hey, you there?
Yeah?
This couple is heading up north to the Boston line. They got money, they'll pay you on arrival. That work for you?
Yeah, sounds fine. Get on in.
Hey, you carry protection on a journey like this?
I wouldn't be much of a stage driver if I didn't. Goes everywhere I do. Hey!
Miss Braithwaite is gonna hold on to this until arrival. Hmm? On account of the treasure on your person.
I don't know how to thank you.
You're a fine man, sir.
Just get out of here. I'll leave.
Yeah!
Reverend?
You okay, Mr. Morgan?
I don't know, Reverend.
These are challenging times. If for all of us.
Yes, very challenging.
You don't seem yourself, somehow. I've always felt... I've left the morphine, sir.
Arthur, Reverend Swanson, would you excuse us a minute?
Of course.
New York. We are going to go to New York. Now, they have been chasing us south and east and west. We're going to get a boat, we're going to get on a river, and we're going to go north.
New York.
Then Tahiti, the Fiji Islands, or this place, New Guinea, dancing girls, freedom. But first, we have to make a whole lot of smoke, a whole lot of commotion. And then we disappear.
We need more commotion?
One score and one whole hell of a lot of noise.
We ain't so good at doing scores anymore, Dutch.
Are you feeling all right, Arthur?
Sure, fine.
Pardon me for interrupting. I brought a friend, Arthur.
Hello.
Hello.
Dutch, this is Eagle Flash. His father is a great chief. Charles and I, we...
pretended to be mercenaries. Did me a great favor.
Dutch Vanderlyn. How do you do?
Not well, sir.
Well, I am sorry to hear that.
How's your father?
Father has confused wisdom with weakness. His people, my people, we've suffered too much, been lied to too much. Now they've taken our horses.
Who?
The infantry division posted at Fort Wallace.
Why?
Colonel Favors is a liar and a murderer. His people won't stop until we're all dead. Without horses, we cannot hunt. Without hunting, we will starve. This is another act of war.
I see that.
You men have helped me before, and I have money.
Put your money away, son. What do you think, Charles?
You know I told your father I will not fight over some horses.
But I made no such promise. Come along.
Yeah. Arthur, we must go with them. To try to stop things from getting out of hand.
I guess. Come along.
We can get them more horses.
I know. I understand Eagle Flies is angry, but I don't see how this will help anything.
Especially not with Dutch whipping them up into a frenzy. We got enough folks coming after us without adding army to the list.
You going to let these bastards walk all over you?
No. You're not. This is all that's wrong with this world.
Okay, young man, lead the way.
The horses are on a boat near Van Horn. I have a man waiting for us there with some canoes.
Surely this can be done without killing anyone.
Of course. What will be, will be. I have a plan. You just have to trust me.
There's Peta. These men, like I said, they'll help us.
I got the canoes. The boat is still moored in the channel.
Good. Let's wait until nightfall. All right. Let's head out.
We need to get that boat ashore. I think the best plan is to paddle up there silently, board her. Then when we got control, we'll deal with that anchor, float away. We'll be ashore before anybody even knows what happened.
Good luck.
Quietly.
try not to kill anyone, Arthur.
I'm gonna go smoke, all right? Be back in a bit.
Oh! No, not again.
Man had a sniff of a good hen all night.
I'll be retiring in the morning at this rate.
Just deal, will ya?
This is it!
Take it back, what's ours?
You ain't nothing but worm thief.
Can't let that last one get away.
Are you dealing with the anchor?
You think I have the first idea how this anchor works?
Just blow it up then. Hurry. Come on, Arthur.
Are confused. We need to round them up. I'll get these more, Arthur. Can you go after the others?
Okay. Come on now. Over here, come on.
Ah, seems like Uncle Sam likes you fellas even less than he likes us.
So it goes. My father doesn't want to fight again.
Will one of you help me return the horses to my men?
Well, Arthur... Arthur needs to rest. I will. I like you, son. And after the horses, are we going to wait for the army to come and wreak its revenge?
I hope not.
Of course we ain't. Now let's go check out that fort of theirs.
Is this a good idea?
This is the only idea. And it is one that will suit both of our purposes.
Fighting the army ain't wise.
Stop worrying. Oh, and Sadie told me about Combe. Meet us at Doyle's Tavern in Saint Denis when you can. Shall we go, son?
Certainly.
We'll start some light reconnaissance out at Fort Wallace, and when Combe's dealt with, you come meet us there. We'll set up a good spot for you.
I don't know, Dutch.
Yeah, well, I do. This is exactly the distraction that we need.
Your father said that fighting was an impossible gamble. There's no winning for you in this.
Your father need not know anything. He'd rather live in ignorance.
Come along, gentlemen.
Your father would rather you did not do anything so foolish. I said I would stop this from happening. Would you talk to him?
Speak with Rangeful.
Yes. Would you?
Sure. Oh. I'll speak with him. It's Dutch's behavior. It's...
I understand.
Thank you, Arthur.
Giddy up. Giddy up. How you doing?
Been thinking more about Dutch and Eagle Flies. It can only end badly.
Well, try to keep your head straight.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
fascinating.
Suéltame! Ayúdame! Socorro! Que alguien me ayude! No me suelta! Señor! Ayúdeme! Me duele! Me desangró!
I got some medicine.
Medicina? ¿Ya para qué? No puedo.
I wouldn't stay around here too long if I was you.
Hey, mister.
We do not want you here. None of us do.
Hello?
Come in. You don't sound very well.
I'm not. I think I'm dying.
Then I hope you find peace.
Well, I don't know too much about peace.
Apparently not. Did you have fun with my son, the impetuous prince? I believe you went on a raid with him.
I'm sorry.
I suppose I lack the grandeur of a conventional king.
I don't know too many kings.
Colonel Favors. He has already exacted some measure of revenge for the raid. Two women were assaulted by his men.
I'm very sorry about all of this.
Yes. Sometimes the correct path, the bravest path, is the least obvious and also the gentlest. I'm a great disappointment to my son.
Your son seems to want a war.
My son thinks there is glory in death. Maybe he's right, but for me, I saw death being handed out so freely by the most foolish of men, I never could equate it with victory. Glory has come in service. Maybe. Maybe not, I don't know.
I've killed a lot of people. For a whole lot of dumb reasons, and I ain't never seen much glory in it.
Well, your friend, Mr. Vanderlyn, he talks a lot. I don't know him, but my son is easily led.
I'm not sure I get you.
Well, perhaps we could go for a ride. I'm an old man. My whole life I have tried to bring peace.
But I ain't doing so good.
Then maybe you can take pity on my plight. Please, it won't take long. And maybe I can help you with that cough.
Sir! I'm glad I caught you, sir.
Captain Monroe, do you know my friend, Mr. Morgan?
No, sir. I don't have the pleasure.
Arthur Morgan.
It's an honor, sir.
How can I help you, Captain?
I was just in Saint Denis. I spoke with the mayor. It's not good news, I'm afraid. May I ride with you for a little?
Of course.
Follow me.
So where are we going?
I want to show you a site up in the mountains that's long been sacred to me. A place for reflection and healing.
Yeah!
What is this news, Captain Monroe?
Yes, sir. As I mentioned, I did speak again with the mayor and the Bureau of Indian Affairs in Saint-Denis at length. But regrettably, it appears the oil company has already received approval to move forward with drilling on the reservation's land.
I suppose there's much. So what does that mean for us now?
I'm not sure just yet. I didn't get the impression anything would be happening for a few months. I'm very sorry, sir. I did everything I could.
I know, Captain.
And I assure you I will continue to do as much as I can. Mr. Morgan, would you have time to help me at all? I would rather certain actions were taken by friends outside the tribe.
Sure, I can help.
See the wolves over there feasting on that horse? Brutality and beauty are both all around us. Yet so often we're unable to see past our own grievances. This is what I try to teach my son.
Yeah! Go on, get out of here!
Good. There was no need to harm them.
So, we don't know each other too well, but I wanted to speak to you about your son. I was there on the raid to steal back those horses, and, well, you know something of Dutch, I think.
Yes, a little. Mostly from your friend Charles.
I don't know why Dutch is getting involved in your situation, and this ain't easy to say, but I just don't trust that he's got your son's best interests at heart.
So what can we do?
I don't rightly know. Charles and I just thought you should be aware. Maybe there's a way to stop things from getting any more out of control.
Thank you, Mr. Morgan. Let me give this some thought. This is what I was looking for. English mace. Okay, let's continue on.
You know, I had a son once, years ago. Don't talk about him much.
No, what was his name?
Isaac. His mother, Eliza, was a waitress I met. When she got pregnant, she knew who I was, what my life was. I didn't want to promise nothing I couldn't keep, but I said I'd do right by them.
Hey!
Every few months, I'd stop by there for a few days. He was such a good kid. She was too, I guess. Just a kid, 19.
What happened?
I got there one day and saw two crosses outside. I knew right away. Turned out some bastards had come through. Robbed them. Shot them dead. And offered $10. It hardened me. Feeling that kind of pain. But I know now that you don't get to live a bad life and have good things happen to you.
I think you're being hard on yourself.
Maybe. All I can do now is try and make something.
Wait, stop here. I want to pick some ginseng. We can talk more about this later. This will combine well. Wait there. I'll put these in your saddlebag. Mix these together. It tastes awful, but it'll help to keep your strength up. All right, let's go. It's not much further now. You were saying before you rode off?
Maybe. All I can do now is try and make some things right. And that feller, Monroe, how you know him?
Captain Monroe was reassigned here from a regiment in the north. Apparently, the news of our conflict has spread all the way to Washington. He's a good man. He wants to help.
Well, I guess that's something at least.
The army aren't all bad men. Just as my people aren't all good. But this Colonel Favors, he walks an old line. He's obstinate and he hates Monroe. I just hope between us we can work this out. Yeah! It's just up ahead. Hold.
What's happened? No! It can't be. No! They destroyed everything! I need to find the Chinupa. Who would do this?
Someone who wanted to enrage you.
Help me look around, please! Buzz gone.
Of course. What is it?
A ceremonial pipe. There must be some clues to what happened here. It's ruined.
There's some logs here they must have used as kindling.
An empty bottle of whiskey.
Well, if they drank all that, they couldn't have gotten too far.
Yeah, well, still no sign of the Chinupa.
There's some whiskey here.
This is a place of peace. Look there! Smoke! Quick, Mr. Morgan! There's someone down there! Do you have any binoculars?
Oh, there they are. These brave men. Some of Colonel Favor's men. They must have been the ones who did this.
Are you surprised this happened?
Not at all. But I hope we were past this.
Well, you got land they want. Land with oil.
They moved us here. They've taken everything we had. I signed 3 treaties myself, and they've broken each one. No, they've taken the last hope. Now my people are going to want a war. A war they can't win.
Not if I get it back.
Get it back?
Yeah, I'm gonna go in, get your Chinupa, no one will be any the wiser.
Would you do that?
Gonna see you in dirt before this is over.
Please tell me you found it.
Here. I got your things, I think.
Yes. Thank you.
I'm very sorry about this.
Even sacred things are only things. People, the heart, matter more. Was anyone hurt?
Yes.
It's a bad business. I should not have let you do this for me. But perhaps it will stop a bigger massacre. With these, maybe I can calm my people. Maybe I can calm my son.
I hope so.
Thank you. Take those herbs I gave you, please. And most of all, I hope you can find peace within yourself.
He's a man who, not so long ago, I would have found weak and pathetic. Now I see as wise and thoughtful and sensible. I would love to help him. Or at least stop Dutch pushing his son to do something real stupid.
This is the spot I was thinking of. Let's cut up this way.
Sure.
There's a nice vantage point up at the top here. Okay, let's dismount here. Best leave the horses back a bit. We'll have a good view over the road from this ledge. Quick as you can. It will be passing through soon.
The wagon should come along this way.
Okay.
You're a good man, Mr. Morgan, but I fear this task to be a fool's errand.
Well, firstly, I'm a long way from a good man. Secondly, fool's errands are my favorite kind of work.
Fair enough. In that case, I can see we shall be great friends.
May I ask you a question?
Of course.
Why don't you just tell all the folk up in Washington what kind of an idiot Colonel Favors is and save us all a lot of bother?
Unfortunately, the government doesn't work quite like that.
If you say so.
There. I think that's the wagon.
All right. Get yourself out of here.
Just remember to keep it clean, understand me?
Don't worry, I'm as clean as they come. All I do is clean. Oh. Yeah, you're all right, girl. Yeah.
From us.
Oh. Hello.
Captain Monroe, I got the medicine.
Oh, wonderful. That's great news, Mr. Morgan.
Yeah, well, don't worry. It didn't go too bad.
Oh, I'll have to take your word for that. We could both swing for this.
Yeah, well, I think I'm a little past caring about hanging, Monroe.
Maybe. I just hope Colonel Favors thinks he was robbed by bandits and not...
Oh, no, I'm still a bandit. There ain't no doubt about that.
Of course. Well, I better get to work. Thank you, Mr. Morgan. Bandit or not, this was a good thing. Maybe it'll get us both killed, but it had to be done.
I hope so.
Ah, there he is. Old Black Lung Morgan.
Shut up.
Was you followed?
Excuse me?
Was you followed?
You know who you're talking to.
I ain't sure. I ain't sure about much no more. All I know is there's law whenever you're around.
Is that so? Because it seems to me that since you've been riding with us, there ain't been nothing but trouble. Stirring things up all the time, getting in Dutch's ear. Seems wherever you is, there's Pinkertons and vice versa. So you better watch your goddamn mouth, boy! Or...
Take it easy, cowboy. You're gonna do yourself a mischief, way your head.
Micah, shut it!
He started it! Dutch says we is to go on with plans to create a diversion. We gotta get some explosives to blow up the bridge. Keep the army out of here a few days.
I think it's a real bad idea.
I don't think Dutch cares too much what you think.
That's clear.
We gotta confuse him one last time. Then he and I will head to Blackwater, collect the money, and help everyone leave. He's got a boat lined up.
Blackwater's a fool's errand. Everyone knows it. Even a greedy moron like you.
It's Dutch's choice, Arthur. You're just a senior gun, same as the rest of us. Only you ain't well.
I'm fine!
Then you'll do Dutch's bidding. Which is robbing a stage that's coming from Annisburg full of explosives.
Rob a stage. All we seem to ever do is rob a stage, you and me.
Not me. You two. I got my own planning to do. You boys got this.
Shit. Guess we have. Come on, Arthur.
And cowpoke. You take it easy. You could do with a vacation, hmm?
All right, let's go.
These people.
Move, you idiot! Move!
Come on, let's get you out of...
See if we can get this back to camp without blowing ourselves up. Nice shooting back there.
Nice drunk playing.
Comes naturally. I could use a drink after that.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, that was close. Don't reckon I'm cut out to be a dynamite wagon driver.
Killing a bunch of folks so we can rob some dynamite, blow up a bridge? Does this make any sense to you?
It's a distraction, so it ain't meant to make sense.
It should to us. It's our plan.
You know, I've had it with the moment.
Whoa!
So, you got it?
We got it. Yes, we got it.
What's wrong, Arthur?
Nothing at all, boss.
John, go drive this over to Bacchus Bridge. Get a hidden ear there.
He really does think he's in charge.
You go on ahead. I need to speak with Arthur. Good work, son.
What's going on?
Listen. I know we ain't always seen eye to eye, and you find me irritating and a threat, and I like to annoy you. But right now, I need better from you, Arthur.
Okay, Micah. Whatever you say.
I ain't the bad guy you think I am, Arthur. But I am a survivor. Stick with me and you'll live. Oh, the bridge is probably a two-man job. You should probably go help Marston.
Why don't you?
Like I said, Dutch and I got planning to do for the train. There's a big picture here, Arthur. Trust me.
Okay, girl.
Arthur.
How you doing?
Nervous, but I've been nervous for a while. I had a lot of time to think in that jail, and I feel like I just don't know Dutch no more.
You ain't the only one.
And this plan to get us out, it just feels, I don't know.
Like you're stringing us along, I know.
Killing in cold blood, revenge, we all do bad things, but he seems to enjoy it now. It's like he just wants to create more enemies, more chaos.
Yeah, I know.
I mean, I love Dutch. He saved me a long time ago. I feel like in Saint-Denis, when I got arrested, maybe he could have done something.
I feel like you should take your woman and child and get lost.
Do you?
You could give something to Jack. It's that or, well, I don't see no way out of this.
But what about loyalty?
Be loyal to what matters.
What are you gonna do?
I'll be okay, but do it for me. It would make me feel good, if that makes any sense.
A little, but...
Listen to me. When the time comes, you gotta run and don't look back. This is over.
And now?
Now we gotta help Dutch give the army one final tweak on its nose.
Yeah, come on. Help me with the rest of this.
Well, it looks like we finally found our calling in life.
Let's ride this thing out onto the bridge. There's a spot about a third of the way across where we can get down underneath to plant the charges. I've already set up the detonator.
Sure. Let's get this over with. You hear about Dutch and Cornwall?
Yeah. This is what I'm talking about. More enemies, more chaos. I mean, all right, stop. Here's good.
We sure got a lot of this stuff.
We'll need it. I'll climb down there. You lower the crates.
All right. Let me know when you're ready. Got it.
Ready when you are. I'm at the bottom of the ladder here to your left. That's the spot. Lower it from there. Okay, start lowering it down. All right, take it slow. That's not something we want to... Okay, good. Grab the other one. Okay, let's go. Nice and easy. Okay, grab yourself a bundle from the box. The bridge is wired to the detonator. We need to attach each of those bundles to the fuses. There's one on each of the main support beams.
Okay.
Okay. I should go get the handcart ready. You okay to finish off down here?
Sure. Go on, I can handle the rest.
I think I hear something coming, Arthur!
Train! Arthur, get up here quick!
Yeah, I'm on my way!
Faster, buddy, come on!
Shit!
Arthur! A train! Come on, quick! Pump this stupid thing! Hard as you can! Let's go! Just get to the end of the bridge and jump! Faster! Get ready to jump! It's right on us! Come on!
Jump!
Thank you.
No problem.
That just ain't how I want to die. Come on. Let's go blow this thing up. I think the line held. You want the honors?
Sure. I guess old Dutch got all the smoke he wants.
Let's hope so.
You really think that'll draw attention away from us?
I guess we'll see. Tell the truth, I ain't even sure I fully understand Dutch's plan with all this.
Like I said, John, when the time comes, you go.
What about loyalty to everything?
You've been loyal. All that ever mattered to me was loyalty. It's all I knew. It's all I ever believed in. Well, not anymore, John. Soon, you gotta go. Go. Don't look back.
I'll think about it.
I've done a lot of thinking. Look at us. Out here risking our necks and for what exactly?
For
an idea that don't work no more.
How you mean?
You know just what I mean. You got a family. You need cash. You need to start building a life for yourself. Me? I need a vacation. And Dutch has all the money for safekeeping.
You know something? Abigail thinks she might know where some of that money is.
Well, you tell her she better make sure. And then come talk to me. And we'll find out just who and what we should be loyal to.
I don't know, Arthur.
Nor do I. But I'm seeing things a lot more clearly now. I wish things were different. But it weren't us who changed.
Yeah!
Hello, Mr. Morgan.
Glad somebody's feeling good about all this.
Have faith, Mr. Morgan.
I'm trying.
Oh, look who it is!
Hello, Karen.
Look who it is! Oh, Arthur. Big, tough Arthur.
Josiah?
I was
Leaving again?
Yes, just leaving. I'll see you soon.
Perhaps.
What do you mean?
Well, if I was you, I'd disappear too. This is all pretty much over.
I'll be back.
No, you won't. Let's not pretend no more. Get out of here.
I'll miss you, Arthur. You've been a fine friend to me.
No, let's not get over sentimental. Well, the place is quiet. Get out of here. You go with my blessing.
Thank you, Arthur.
Found a friend looking for you.
Mr. Morgan.
Sir.
How are you?
A little better.
I hope so.
How can I help you?
I am sorry to impose on you again, but I believe I've made progress brokering peace.
You have?
I believe so. Colonel Favors has agreed to a meeting to discuss and maybe resolve his alleged grievances and mine. Now, he has lied to me more times than I care to remember, but maybe this time... He must want peace. Why could he possibly want to humiliate us further?
We got words for his kind, but they're colloquial.
Perhaps I could make one last request. My men are not allowed to carry arms.
You want us to keep the peace?
Yeah, it'll be a lot of dull talking and ceremony. But I feel with some non-tribe members present, their chances of lying or worse will be reduced.
Will you, Arthur? It ain't my business, brother.
No, I know. But it is mine. Do it for me.
Charles, I got...
I've saved your life. Do it for me.
Sure. Come on. You owe this man. You should have him do your negotiations.
Let's go.
Come on, maybe this way. I also have some men meeting me there. I wasn't sure if you'd be able to help. Thank you for doing this, both of you. You have already done so much.
Ain't a problem. Just hope nobody recognizes me. I've had a few run-ins with the army recently.
I wish we could have done more to control the situation. Dutch should not have gotten involved.
My son has a mind of his own. Too much so, in fact. I just hope Colonel Favors can be reasoned with. I am not asking for very much, but when our people are sick and hungry, and we find our medicine and supplies are being deliberately withheld, how can we not view that as something personal?
It's part of the reason they're doing these things. Because they want you to fight. To be able to say, look, you see how these savages behave?
Perhaps. Thank you for helping Captain Monroe to retrieve those vaccines, Arthur. He will be at the meeting and is one person who knows the true situation, at least. I still have hope that we can come to an agreement.
Yeah!
up ahead.
Hello.
Whoa. We chasha killer now. Kala with Yampi. Hiopo. Kunyapi Ktelo.
Take care.
This way.
Slow it down.
Colonel Favors, Captain Munro, we come in peace.
Hello again. Who are these two?
They're friends of my people.
Interesting looking fellows.
Yeah, they won't cause any trouble.
Well, I should hope not.
Yeah.
Listen, Mr.
Chief.
Yes, Mr. I can't say that silly name, what is it?
In English, they call me Rainsfall.
Yes, yes, I'm sure they do. Listen, we're all Americans here, and we want an outcome. But quite frankly, I'm confused. Your men are little more than criminals, in my opinion. Keep breaking peace treaties we've made, causing disturbances in everybody's lives. But I pride myself on being a gentleman. Really, I do. But there are limits. So, let me be very... Are you okay, man? Someone. Jackson, take him away. Where was I?
You're a gentleman with limits?
Are you being facetious, sir?
Come this way, buddy.
I said... Are you being facetious, Captain Munro?
That's, Rains' fault.
Exactly. Chief Rains, the thing
is... quite a cough. Federal government.
Sure.
Wait here. Situation. I'll fetch you some water.
I'll be fine. Thank you.
No, no. You know he's going to have Munro court-martialed. Or attempt to. He's going to make a disgrace of him.
Munro? He seems likable enough for a West Pointer. Why?
You know what Favors is like. Because he thinks it's right. Because he thinks Munro is a patsy. Or a spy. He's convinced he had something to do with those vaccines getting stolen. He thinks Munro is going to force him into making a concession with the Indians. So he removes Munro.
Removes how?
Favors wants him tried for treason. And hanged.
Why does Favors care about the Indians?
Because he doesn't want to back down. I mean, his whole professional life. You know what they say about him. Hightail Favors. The man who missed a battle.
Poor Munro. Kind of liked him.
I know. Well, still, he's kind of stuck up.
Your men violated the treaty. That treaty is null and void. I have been appointed to negotiate.
Feeling better?
Yeah. Come on. Let's go.
The lands you currently occupy belong to the United States government. Why is this so confusing, sir? Why?
Good day, Colonel Favors.
Well, that was remarkably unproductive. I'm afraid the federal government was quite clear, Colonel, that it wanted peace, and peace for all, and that the treaty had not been broken by anybody.
Oh, is that so, sir? And did it want impudence, sir, from a junior officer in public? You insult me. You insult the regiment. Arrest this man.
Arrest me?
Gross insubordination. Disobeying an order. Treason.
Are you mad?
You had those vaccines stolen. You disrupted a negotiation.
Let him go.
This is all getting out of hand.
Hi.
Captain Munro, let's get out of here.
If I
were you, I'd keep my mouth shut, amigo. I don't want to kill this man, but shall.
You won't get away with this.
Charles, Captain Munro, mount up now. We're getting out of here.
What you're doing?
You son of a bitch. Get off me.
Open fire on me. Out this way. Come on.
It's okay.
Not really. What do we do now?
You get out of here. Fast. Take you to the station.
I can't believe that just happened. I've been an army man my whole life.
I heard them talk. They was gonna have you hang for treason. You can't die for those fools.
And what about the chief?
We'll do what we can.
I guess I won't be submitting my report.
I wouldn't think so. Get out of here, Captain Monroe.
I fear it may be Mr. Monroe from now on.
I'm sorry about your career. Here. Here's some money. You take it and get out of here and start a new life somewhere. I hear Tahiti's nice.
Thank you.
Just hop on a train to San Denis, jump on a boat, but avoid Guam.
Where?
Forget about it.
Meet you back at camp.
Mr. Morgan! Are you okay?
Yeah. Never better. What are you doing here?
Well, I'm on my way down to Mexico. They're finally sending me on a mission. Brother Dorkins is very jealous. What's wrong?
I'm dying, sister.
Okay.
Yeah, I got TB. I got it. Beating a man to death for a few bucks. Downs! Oh, Mr. Downs! Pay the money. We took your word. You borrowed money from my business partner, Herr Strauss. You owe him. You took the money. He wants it back. What's not to understand? I've lived a bad life, sister.
We've all lived bad lives, Mr. Morgan. We all sin. But I know you.
You don't know me.
Forgive me, but that's the problem. You don't know you.
What do you mean?
I don't know, but whenever we happen to meet, you're always helping people and smiling.
I had a son. He passed away. I had a girl who loved me. I threw that away. My mama died when I was a kid, and my daddy, well, I watched him die, and it weren't soon enough.
My husband died a long time ago. Life is full of pain, but there is also love and beauty.
What am I gonna do now?
Be grateful that for the first time, you see your life clearly.
Sure.
Perhaps you could help somebody. Helping makes you really happy.
But I still don't believe in nothing.
Often, neither do I. But then I meet someone like you, and everything makes sense.
You're too smart for me, sister. I guess I'm afraid.
There is nothing to be afraid of, Mr. Morgan. Take a gamble that love exists and do a loving act.
All aboard!
I shall try.
I know you will.
Mr. Morgan. Goodbye.
Sister.
About me.
There you are.
Here I am.
Come on, let's go.
Let's go where? And why are you so riled up?
Today is a great day, Arthur. Today is the day they are going to hang Colm O'Driscoll.
That's so.
Rather they hang him or I shoot him.
Oh, they are gonna hang him.
Yeah, and not before time.
That boy's been on the gallows more than most. I wouldn't count anything until his neck's broke.
Well, nor would I. Which is why, despite us being wanted men, we're gonna attend the event ourselves.
And follow him onto the scaffold?
Well, let's hope not. But if I could see that son of a bitch breathe his last, I think I'd die a happy man. We are gonna disguise ourselves.
In this?
In this.
Come on. We got a hanging to witness.
Look here, don't the public love an execution? Hey.
All right, good. Now,
you see that pair of assholes?
Sure.
They're Colm's boys.
Yes, I think so.
What a surprise. I'm glad we're here. What are they pointing at?
I don't know. We gotta follow them and find out.
Yeah. Oh, here comes somebody.
Go brush that horse, officer.
Yes, sir.
The crowd came to see a show. We don't want to disappoint them.
Guess they did miss their chance to see John swing by his neck.
Hey, hey! You know I wasn't going to let it come to that.
I guess I don't know what I know no more.
And I guess this isn't the time to question either my decisions or yours. Here and now, Colm O'Driscoll's going to get his due. He's turned down there.
Bunch of cops. How many?
Enough. So what do you think?
Paul's up on the roof. Once he starts shooting, we have to have our wits about us and move fast.
Yeah. I guess we face worse than this before.
Sure. Let's get to it.
Yeah.
So, they got a guy up on the roof overlooking the gallows. Find a way up there onto one of these verandas, through a building maybe. Get him. And do it silently.
Well, obviously, I'm gonna do it silently. I wanna see this bastard swing.
Oh, Arthur. Here's a ladder. Mrs. Adler.
Thank you.
What's this, Dan? A gun case. Your boss is gonna swing, I promise. Well, Combe, there goes your escape plan.
Fair citizens of Saint-Denis, for as long as any of us can remember, it is justice that separates us from barbary. Yet justice itself can at times be barbaric. For sometimes a man is so savage, the only way to deal with him justly is by savagery. Combe O'Driscoll is one such man. He has murdered, tortured, robbed, stolen, raped, and abused for a decade across five states, seemingly with impunity. Today, justice catches up with him.
As well you may. I've been a bad man.
Silence!
These charges are...
This is not a court where you shall be tried. This is a place where your sentence is to be carried out. And your sentence, Combe O'Driscoll, is that you are to be hanged by the neck until you are dead. This is not a task we take lightly. It is not a task we enjoy. But it is a task we must carry out if our civilization is to prosper. Gentlemen, are we ready? Combe O'Driscoll, may God, in his infinite wisdom, have mercy upon your soul. Whenever you are ready.
Now you know how it feels to watch somebody you love die. You ruined my life!
Morgan, you hear us? Take a shot on these O'Driscolls!
I'm gonna put a window in your skull! There are no more matches left to get between us!
I can't get a shot on him!
How you get on, Arthur?
Well, we saw the bastard hang okay, but the whole thing ain't gonna save us.
I guess that's one less thing to worry about.
I guess, compared to the entire government, in the end, Combe O'Driscoll didn't seem like such a worry.
A letter came for you.
Oh, okay.
I know it's from that Mary.
Mary?
She ain't worth it, Arthur.
Who is?
My dear Arthur, you never showed up.
And now, after looking at the newspapers, I understand why. I don't imagine you'll receive this letter, but I, nonetheless, must send it. Arthur.
Arthur.
Where'd he go?
I don't know. He left me a note. Told me I should do the same.
Why?
Well, I think he's worried.
He's a right to be worried. You worried?
Sure, but I still think maybe things will turn out okay. You'll steer Dutch right. I know you will.
I'll try, Miss Grimshaw. Really, I will.
Come on now. Open, will you?
Yeah.
So good of you to join us.
What's going on?
Rebellion. The smell of cordite and integrity. It is a beautiful thing.
What are y'all doing?
An eye for an eye. We didn't start this, Arthur. They did.
We? This ain't our fight.
It surely is.
Whatever it is you're planning, it ain't a good idea. They want you to fight.
Nobody will be killed.
We're just gonna trap a few of them in the valley, disarm them, tar and feather them, and remind them to leave these boys alone.
You have energy for pranks?
Come on, Arthur. Just tweaking Uncle Sam's nose a little. I need you to help me.
So, you're using them?
No, sir. No. Never.
But it is mutually beneficial to draw attention to one problem and a veil over another.
These are good people, but their situation is real complex. We ain't helping them.
Sure we are. Come on, let's get this done.
We don't have a lot of time. The patrol should be coming in a few minutes.
Okay. Hurry, Arthur. I'll plant the dynamite, you run the wire.
We'll keep lookout from up here.
I sent for some of that dynamite you and Bill commandeered in Van Horn. Good work with that, by the way.
Bill played drunk.
The perfect man for the job.
So, you finally got to see Colm Hank.
Yeah. After all those years, hard to believe. Oh, but it was worth the wait. See? We're tying up the loose ends, Arthur. One by one.
Distance.
The detonator's by me. Here.
My spotter will let us know when they're near.
They're coming now. Ah, damn. Patrol's a lot larger than we thought it was gonna be.
Don't worry. That's a good thing.
Okay, that's the signal. Here they come. Stay low and quiet.
You sure you don't want me to man that plunger, Arthur?
No, I got it.
Oh, remove the weight of the world from your shoulders for a minute. Like I said, we're just going to give them a bit of a scare.
There they are. Looks like more than we thought.
It's fine. We're only here to talk and administer a little good old-fashioned humiliation. You're owed that, son, at the very least.
Wait for my lead, men.
Everyone just stay calm. We've got the upper hand here. Okay, they've passed the first charge. If we blow it now, we should have them trapped.
Put your hands up! You're surrounded! Nobody need get hurt! Your humiliation of us has gone on quite enough.
This ain't a good idea!
Put down your guns!
You are making a mistake, boy!
No, you're making a mistake. Put your hands up, soldier. Take a little humiliation and leave these fine folks alone.
Who are you?
A concerned citizen.
Is that so?
What now?
We should move.
No, not quite yet. Soldier, you and your friends gonna tuck tail and run off? Run!
Excuse me?
I'm getting bored of this. Your friends fired first, soldier!
About this.
They fired first, son.
Take them down!
Is this what you wanted?
You started this!
There's another patrol in the rear!
Looks like we got a fight then, boy!
We will kill you all, if that's what it takes!
I'll kill you all! It's time you paid for what you've done!
This is bad. Look out! They're coming up on our left! You pushed us to this. There's a lot of them. Kill him. Watch your heads.
You fools, you damn fools, it's the army.
It is one regiment of pastry chefs and bullies. Watch your goddamn mouth. All of you, take what you can, and then we move out.
Move now. We have to move now.
Search these men quickly, then we move.
This is crazy. Why aren't we getting out of here?
They might have information on them that'll help our friends with their cause.
We need anything my father can use to strengthen our case. Don't forget what these men did to our women, our children.
Find anything?
Yes. Some poor fool from New Jersey. These boys ain't the problem. They're only kids.
Keep looking. Shit! Everyone, keep your heads down! We're gonna get out of this!
Got it! Stupid murder bastards! Are you alright?
I think so.
No papers! Fight for this, you die like what do we do here, Dutch? This is a lot of men!
Just hold your ground! Surrender! Try to flank them, Arthur. We'll shoot you some space.
Yes! We need to take out that cannon!
Up the hill! The cannon! Take out the spotter, Arthur!
You're a dead man! Where's Peta?
Graham, we're sending riders from the fort. We need to leave.
But where's Peta? Was he killed? He's alive.
Well, that went just about according to plan.
I'm trying. I'm trying, Arthur, with everything I have, and I will keep trying, and you'll keep doubting me, and we'll keep failing.
It ain't like that, Dutch. Look at me. Look at me! I'm worried about folk.
I know.
We should go.
Where's Eagle Flash?
Run, son! Run!
Come on!
This area's gonna be crawling with soldiers in a few minutes. We gotta leave. Now!
What about Eagle Flies?
We gotta go, Arthur! Come on! We need to ride hard! Stay with me! Left here! Into the trees! Okay, let's dismount here. We won't get the horses down this path. All right, let's carry on by foot, try and sell them a little snake oil.
You think?
It's all I got. Get out of here. Yeah! Let's see if we can lose them down here.
You're gonna die,
Shit!
I guess not. Get behind something, Arthur! Let's drill these bastards clean! Come on, let's see if there's a way out through here.
This is where you die!
You're dead.
More on the left!
Die! I'm putting you down!
Behind us! Hold them off! Well, Arthur.
Put your hands up! I said put your damn hands up!
Okay. Okay. Follow my lead. I got a plan. This is a good one. Hello, officers!
You keep them hands up and come here. Put your hands up!
Hello, Captain.
Keep your hands up and come here. Come here.
We can't do that. Your man... Those men they killed? They were good men. You're fighting nature, Captain.
Get over here!
Ask my friend here. My whole life, I tried to fight change. It's a waste. I see that. Now, it's a waste. You can't fight nature, Captain. You can't fight change. You can't fight.
Thank you.
here, big boy!
I got you!
You're okay. You're okay.
What a mess.
I know. But a mess is what we need. Oh, we just escaped from chaos. Eagle Flies must have been taken.
Taken or killed.
Well, we can't go find out.
No, not now.
Charles, we'll send them. Where is it?
He's probably back at camp.
Let's split up. I'll go tell him. You rest up, then go meet him up at the reservation. We are gonna make it, brother. I can feel it. Faith, Arthur. Have faith.
Arthur.
Hello, Charles. Thank you for coming.
Of course.
The chief, he's very... You could speak to him?
Yes, that's why I came.
He's in his tent.
Joe.
I'll wait for you here. We can trust him.
Hello?
Come in. Mr. Morgan. I'm so glad you could make it.
How are you?
My son. My son is foolish, but he's still my son.
I know your son. A little. Yeah. He's very brave. Very angry. He's me.
How is your father?
He's dead a long time. He lived a lot longer than was good for any of us.
My son probably wishes the same to me.
I doubt that.
I want peace. I need my people to be safe. All my life I've tried to bring peace. But I love my son. They'll hang him for treason. Treason. He is the chief son of a proud nation. How could he commit treason? People who have lied to my people for 100 years or more, that's treason.
Well,
what should I do?
I don't think there's much chance reasoning with Colonel Favor.
No. And any chance we had, your friend, Mr. Vanderland, has ensured relations between us and the army are worse than any point in the last 5 years. I'm sure he means well. But matters are more complex than he understands.
Me and Charles will try and rescue your son.
No.
Yes, yes. I ain't got much to lose, and you got... I'm doing this. Charles! Where are you? Come on, let's go. We need to get his son back, of course. I just ain't sure how.
I've been working on that. I think there's a way. Follow me.
I didn't tell you before, but... I saw a doctor. It's pretty bad. Well, it's gonna get worse.
Snap out of it, Arthur. Oh, Arthur. Any day, we can die. Hmm? We're riding to break an Indian chief's son out of a cavalry fort. We could both die tonight. In a way, it is a gift to know. In a way, you are lucky. Sure don't feel like that.
You still have time to make amends. The others, Hosea, Lenny, Sean, all them, they didn't. And what about the Calendar boys? Both killed trying to escape Blackwater? More vicious pair of bastards than ever was. And that's all they ever were and will be.
Maybe.
You're lucky. You got the chance to do something better. My guess is maybe that's why you're here now. Either way, just keep your head strong. We're close now. Are you all right?
I think so.
That current's strong. Up here. Follow me.
You were right about the damn rain.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But might help us with sneaking in there. The Rainsfall told me there was some retaliation after the meeting with Colonel Favors. Some women were taken. Elders beaten.
Bastards.
Yeah. This isn't gonna be nice. There it is.
All right. This should be fun. Let's get ourselves hidden and wait till it gets dark.
Over here.
I guess this is it.
I guess it is.
Let's keep quiet. We'll try and find a way in. Main thing is that they don't hear us. You ready?
Got a shot on him? Good. Let's move. Another one up ahead. Let's move. Come on. Careful. Two more. Good work. Come on. Come on. We're good. There's a guard out front. You take him. I'll cover back there.
Try to put an arrow into the lantern above that stack of wood over there. Start a fire.
Let's go!
Arthur, come on! Get down here!
Move quickly. The cells are just in here.
Pull a fast move in your brain. That a joke? No. No joke. Not funny.
Arthur Morgan? Charles? Is that you?
Got him. Come on. Your father sent us?
My father? He told you to come and kill guards?
No, he didn't say that, he.
Of course not.
You okay?
Sure. Enjoy being tortured. Clears the mind.
If you say so. Whoa, whoa.
I'm fine, I'm fine.
Shit! I don't think we're sneaking out of here, fellas.
Come on, all three of you!
Got me! Come on, move up!
Down by the river.
They had a chance.
Let's just get you to safety first, my friend.
It's like Dutch said.
They only have power when you allow them to have it.
Well, Dutch is over.
Watch out for the current! Look out! On the shore! They're coming after us!
Shit!
We lost them.
Come on. You okay, Arthur?
Yeah, I'm right as rain. How are you?
I'll be fine in a day or so. I heal fast. Colonel Favors won't be too happy with your rescue.
I guess not.
Yeah, there's gonna be a lot more trouble. My father, even he may have to fight.
You won't win. No big fight with them. Shouldn't y'all just run away?
Where would we go?
I don't know.
In front. Let me take you back to your father.
Thank you.
No mention. Yeah. Come on, girl.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Arthur.
Mrs. Adler?
You okay?
Peachy.
You sure?
No, I ain't sure.
You still working?
Is anybody still working? The whole goddamn place full of people bickering, fighting, and lying. It makes me real sad.
I know. I need someone to ride with me.
To do what?
Finish off them O'Driscolls. I hear the last of them is holed up at Hanging Dog Ranch.
I don't have it in me no more. I saw Colm swing. I just don't care.
I was a married woman. You know what they did to me and to my husband? Look, you're the only one of these fools that I trust. I've got to do this.
I'll tell you what, I'll do it, but there's something you could help me with.
Sure.
You, me, and John. This whole thing is pretty much done, but Dutch still has our money hidden away, so...
But how do you mean?
When the time comes, just be ready.
What do you mean?
I mean, if we can get out of here with money, you and me, we ain't... We're more ghosts than people. And none of that loyalty matters.
Jesus. Okay. I'm with you.
Well, then you got yourself a gun. What's left of one?
Thank you, Arthur. You want to ride with me now, or meet me up at Hanging Dog Ranch when you can? Thanks, Arthur. Okay. Come on.
Find mourning for a killing.
Hey.
You seen anything down there?
Yeah, I think there's a bunch of them down there. I'm mostly drunk. But one of them is a fat fellow with a beard. Him? He's mine.
Okay.
It's a big ranch. Run down. Lots of folk there. But spread pretty thin. I'll set it off, and then we'll take it from there.
Take it from there? Okay. So, no real plan then?
Oh, I got a plan. Now, come on.
Is that a woman? Jesus! Who the hell is that lady? That's the Hellcat saw Combs swing!
Count! Let's get down!
He was a good man, my Jakey. We was always sweet on one another.
I'm sure.
Yeah. I miss him every day, every moment. They turned me into a monster, Arthur. But my memories of him, they still pure.
I ain't even got that.
You know, you're a confusing man, but you might just be the best friend I got, Arthur.
I know the company you keep. The competition ain't too fierce. We should get away from her. Yeah.
I think I need to be alone for a bit.
I understand. You, might want to get yourself cleaned up.
Thank you, Arthur.
You're blowing my life.
So why are these two still here?
Old pals of Micah's.
They're getting real comfortable.
We need guns for what's coming. Cleet and Joe know how to fight. It's lucky I bumped into them.
What is going on, Dutch? What is happening to us? What's happening to you?
You show him some respect.
Excuse me?
Mr. Vanderlyn! Mr. Morgan! Charles! They try to kill my people for oil! For oil! Today we ride once more! Ride with me! Ride with us! Ride with us against the factory!
I love your courage, son! It is a thing of great beauty!
Stop! Everyone, stop!
My son! My last son! Don't! When I was your age, I fought. I saw death. I have killed. The men I knew were slain. My firstborn, your brother, had his head smashed by a drunken soldier. My wife had her throat slit. I made peace. I knew not to trust, yet I had no choice. Maybe you were right. Maybe the slow death is worse than the fast one. Maybe none of these men are good. Maybe a world in which they came to us is a world that we cannot endure. But endure we must.
Father, you are tired.
Do not die for pride, my son. We have suffered too much in this trick. The earth, the water, they have no pride. They endure. And we must endure. My only boy, my precious boy, do not mistake my strength for weakness. As your chief, I implore you.
Your words mean nothing to me, Father.
Don't.
Run with me! Now!
Stop. Please, stop. Please. Mr. Morgan, after you helped me after we spoke, this is just a trap. My son, my people, will all die.
You help this fellow, Arthur?
Please.
What of it?
What else you been doing behind Dutch's back?
What?
The wars are over. We have lost. These young men will be annihilated. Please.
I'll see what I can do, Charles. Who else will come with me?
Oh, I'll ride, Arthur. Who knows what other secrets I'll learn about? Who else?
I will.
And me. Me too.
Locke. And me. I guess.
All right. Let's ride out. What else have you been doing behind my back, Arthur?
I was trying to stop this mess from getting any worse. Maybe that didn't work.
Why the hell would they attack the oil fields?
What do you mean? It's perfect.
This was your idea?
Partly. The army, the government, the industrialists. They've taken everything from these people. Wouldn't you want to fight back?
Handed them a death sentence.
Just like John if we hadn't got him out of that prison.
Hey, show some goddamn respect.
Look out!
You'll know when I ain't showing respect, Bill.
I had a plan. I still have a plan.
What plan? What goddamn plan, Dutch? Tahiti? Timbuktu?
That's enough. What's wrong with you all? What happened to loyalty?
Yeah, what did?
Thank you, Javier. Bill, right now, it doesn't matter how we got here. These men need our help. I have a plan. This is the plan. So either stick with me or cut loose. Because I am tired of this constant descent. Long tired of it. Now come on! one of them? Are you all right, son?
Eagle flies! He needs help! They all need help!
Quick! Somebody help
him! No! No! Go! Please hurry! I'll be...
Come on! Yeehaw!
Massacre.
We gotta help these men.
Can anyone see eagle flies?
There. Going across the walkway.
Got what you wanted, Dutch.
You coming, Arthur?
I'm gonna try and save him. This fight is unwinnable. You go and distract them and let me get to him.
Have it your way. The rest of you, ride with me. Let's meet up at the factory. Let's ride! Yeah!
Go with him. Try and help there, I'm better off alone.
We're riding with you.
Come on then.
Let's ride!
My men. Where are my men?
We saw some fighting by the factory. That's where Dutch is gone.
Let's go, quick!
Any men we see, we must save them.
Find the others. We need to get to the factory building.
We'll kill all of you.
Bunch of goddamn cowards.
Bunch of cowards. This regiment is a joke.
You're gonna kill him. He's all East today.
You too, bro!
So good of you to join us. Hello, son.
Hey.
Saved your life.
He did.
Hey, you're quite the hero, Arthur, ain't you?
Just a regular good guy, same as always.
What is it with you, Arthur? What is it?
I don't get you. I don't get you no more.
Oh, the doubting. The doubting. Come on, get him out of here. All of you. Come on. Let's go finish things.
Finish what?
Oh, the doubts. You know why I wanted them to attack this place?
I have no idea.
Javier, you get them and you go.
Until I find all my men. I'm not leaving.
As you wish. Rest of you, get out of here.
I'm staying with you.
We're getting our ticket out of here. We need to find the office.
It's upstairs on the other side. I broke in here before to get those papers for Eagle Flies.
That's better, Arthur. A little help.
Come on, son. What are we looking for?
Money, you fool. The money. There's state bonds here. Lots of them. I thought you were paying attention. Old Cornwall had a deal with the state. He was being paid to develop the region against the federal government's wishes, as they didn't want problems with the Indians. Anyway.
So we get it, and we're done? We're almost free?
Yes. If we're right. We've had tough times. The toughest of times. But come on. Don't doubt me no more. Search the place. They gotta be here somewhere.
I don't know. I've been here before.
Check that cupboard by the door.
I got some cash. Not much.
I got him. This is it. It's state bonds.
How much?
It's a few thousand dollars worth, maybe more. Oh, we are nearly there. Arthur, we're nearly there. Mr. Morgan, let's go home. Here, Arthur. Did you hear that?
Gentlemen! We're here for you!
Your friend?
Get in there! Shoot him! Find him! Now! Come on!
Should be.
Come on.
We need to go.
You ran away.
Oh, I did no such thing. Don't be a fool. They could be back here any minute. We did it, gentlemen. Well, we got some money. And with the train job, well, we got a whole lot of money. Come on. Everything is coming together. Exactly as I planned.
I've got to take the boy to his father.
As you wish. Usually is nowadays.
Sure.
Come on! We got to get back to camp and prepare! Let's ride!
I'll be back when I can.
I'll stay with you.
And me, of course.
And so will I.
No, get out of here. Please. This ain't gonna be nothing nice.
Be safe, Arthur.
All right, come on. Let's get him to Wapiti as fast as we can. Hold on, my friend.
Our men. We must go back for the bodies.
My friend, I'm sorry. About this. About all of this.
You have nothing to be sorry for!
You know, Dutch... Dutch is... I guess my thinking is he used you. He wasn't trying to help anyone but himself and his own crazy principles.
We're grown men. Nobody made us do anything.
Maybe I'm talking for my people as much as for yours. We saw he turned crazy and... We couldn't believe it, and we followed him anyway. Things should never have gone this far.
You seen the situation on the reservation?
Wait, Arthur!
Now, as I was saying, you seen the situation on the reservation? Better to die fighting than sick and weak.
Maybe, but you... Your people deserve better. You okay, Charles?
Not really. All this death, and for what? Just so we can have enough money to be able to run away from what we've done?
There used to be some reason to it. Lines that couldn't be crossed. We even helped some folk. Those lines have been gone for some time now.
The time has come for us to draw our own lines, Arthur. Decide where we go from here.
I swear, back there, Dutch just stood and watched. If it wasn't for Eagle Flies, I'd be...
I know. I feel like he's descended into the kind of man he told us never to be.
Maybe. He's just become more who he really is. I don't know anymore. I just feel like a fool.
That money, those bonds, whatever it is, I don't want a cent. There's too much blood on it.
Let's just get this boy to his father. Your friend here, my friend, he's a brave man.
Fearless. Always has been. This won't be in vain. We will try to round up more men from the north, wherever we can. Many are ready to fight.
No, this is over for all of us.
Peta!
Yes.
Peta!
It's okay, brother. Save your breath. We're not too far.
Son! I think he's been shot! Oh, no. He is wounded.
Bring him to me. My son.
What are they gonna do now?
They must move. And fast.
I'll stay and help them.
Yeah, I'll stay too.
No, my friend. You have others who need you. Good people. I'm sorry, but we must pack and move.
Tongue can tell. Ooh, you Shaken.